Hello everyone, welcome to the channel Unshackling Sudokus and Puzzles. I'm Kishore and today we are going to solve an anti-knight arrow Sudoku created by Tenali Raman. This Sudoku was published by Tenali Raman on the Logic Masters Germany portal. The Sudoku has received a decent rating. The LMD portal has some amazing Sudokus and puzzles. I will add the link to the LMD portal. Please do check out the portal. And you'll also find the online solving link for this Sudoku in the description of the video, so that if you want to give it a try, please do so. And before moving on to the video, please subscribe to the channel. If you have been enjoying the content that we are producing each day, please subscribe to the channel. Please hit the bell button below now. So let us move on to the rules. Normal classic rules apply. Each row, each column and each 3x3 box contains the digits from 1 to 9 without repetition. And the next part is anti-knight. Digits which are knights move away cannot be the same. So a knight moves two steps in one of the orthogonal directions and then one step in the perpendicular direction. So for example, if you have a, let's say, 5 here, then all these cells cannot contain 5. So you can reach all of these steps by moving two steps in one of the orthogonal directions and then one step in the perpendicular directions. So this is how a knight moves. So digits which are a knight's move apart cannot contain the same digit. The next part of the rule is that arrow. There are some arrows shown in the grid. So this is the arrow sum and then there is a stem originating from the arrow sum. So the digits in the arrow path must add up to the digit in the circle cell. So when you sum the digits along the arrow, you will end up having the digit in the circle of the arrow. Digits may repeat along an arrow provided there is no violation of standard classic rules. So with that, we'll start solving the Sudoku. The design is pretty striking if you see, and it is really hard to believe if this Sudoku will have a unique solution, because there is not much information in the grid and even the arrows are not that many in number. So let us start with this arrow, because it seems to be very restricted, right? From this arrow we have 3 arrow stems originating and each of them are 3 in length, right? So now the first step to solving this Sudoku is that we have to use group sum logic here. So let us try to get the minimum sum of all these arrow stems, right? So we know that this circle is having 3 arrow stems and each of the arrow stem must have the same sum because they are connected to the same circle. So which means that if you add all of these arrow stems and then divide by 3, you must get the digit in the circle, right? So now there are 6 cells right in box 1 which are the arrow stems, right? So all these cells are in box 1 and there are 6 cells exactly, and they add to a minimum of 21, right? Because when you have add from 1 to 6, you will get 21. So the minimum sum from each of these 6 cells will be 21. And then we have 3 more cells here, right? We have 3 more cells here. So the minimum sum from these 2 cells will be 3. And then this cell can be minimum 1. So we get a total of 4 from here. So you have 21 from here minimum and 4 from these cells. So when you add 21 and 4, you have a total of 25, right? And when you divide 25 by 3, you are getting something more than 8, right? So this means, this is clear to us that this cell will have a value more than 8. It cannot have 8 or anything less than 8, because the total when you add all the arrow stems gives you 25, which is more than 24. If you have 24, then you can be certain that it must be 8 or 9. But since you have 20 more than 24, then this cell cannot be 8. So it has to be a 9, right? So now let us try to use some minimum maximum concept to see if we can progress in the Sudoku. Okay, one thing which is clear is that since all of these arrow stems are 3 in length, you can easily eliminate the 8 from these arrow stems, because if you have 8 in them, then the minimum total becomes 10. 8 plus 1 plus 1 will give you 10. So 8 will be outside the arrow stems. Okay, so we already established that the minimum sum here must be 21 and the minimum sum here must be 4, right? When these add up to 3 and this must be 1, so the minimum is 4. So let us try to see the maximum values to get the range of both of these sum parts, right? So we know that these arrow stems add to 27 now, because 9 is here, and when you multiply that by 3, you will have 27, right? So why I am multiplying by 3 is that because you have 3 arrow stems, and each arrow stem adds up to 9, and when you multiply 9 by 3, you get 27. So can you have 24 from here? We know that minimum is 21, but can we have 24 from here? If you have 24 from these 6 cells, we know that these 3 cells will add to a minimum of 4. So 24 plus 4 gives you 28, which is more than 27. So we are certain that the total here must be 23 or lesser. Can we have 23? 23 is possible, because 23 plus 4 is 27. So the range here is 21 to 23, right? And correspondingly, the range from these 3 cells must be, if this is 21, then this must be 6. So that 21 plus 6 is 27. And if it is 22, then these 3 cells must add up to 5. So that 22 plus 5 is 27. And if this is 23, then these 3 cells must add up to 4. 23 plus 4 is 27. Okay. So the range in these 3 cells now is 4 to 6. Okay. Sum of these 3 cells must be either 4 or 6. So which gives us that we can, I think, restrict the values in each of these cells. The maximum sum is 6 from each of these 3 cells. So this can be maximum 4, right? It cannot be anything more than 4, because if you have 5, 5 plus 1 plus 1 gives you 7, and that is more than the 6. So you can have a maximum of 4, in which case you will have 1 in both of these cells. Let us restrict the values here now. Can this be a 4? If you have a 4 here, then these two add up to minimum 3, and that gives you 7. So this must be capped by 3, 1, 2 and 3. And this also must be capped by 3. It cannot be 4, because then 1 plus 2 will be 3 and 4 plus 4 will be 7. So the maximum values in these cells must be 3, right? Okay. So we know that the sum here, sum range here is 21 to 23, right? The highlighted cells, the sum range is from 21 to 23. Can we establish some fixed digits inside those orange highlighted cells? I think we can. So one must certainly be inside these orange cells, because if you don't have one, then you must have minimum sum 2, 3, 4 and 5, 6 and 7, right? Which gives you 9, 14, 20 and 27. That is way higher than what we want. So one is definitely in these orange cells, right? One is definitely in those cells. So let me mark the one here. One is definitely here. Can we go without the two? So the minimum sum must be 1, 3, 4, 5, 6 and 7, which gives you 8 plus 13, 19, 26. Again, it is more than the range, permitted range, which is 23. So you must have 22 also inside here. I mean 2 also inside that range. Can we go without the 3? If you go without the 3, 1 plus 2 plus 4 plus 5 plus 6 plus 7 gives you 7, 12, 18, 25. Again, more than the range, right? So we also must have the 3 inside the orange cells. Can we go without the 4? 1, 2, 3, 5, 6, 7. So 6 plus 18, which is 24. Again, one more than the permitted range. So 4 also must be here. Because if you don't have anything of 1, 2, 3, 4 here, the sum total becomes more than the permitted range, which we deduced as 21 to 23, right? Can you have without the 5? I think that is possible, because 1 plus 2 plus 3 plus 4 is 10. And then without the 5, you'll have 6 and 7, which gives you 23, which is perfectly fine. So we are not yet sure what are the balance cells. So I'll remove the highlighting now. So one thing we know here is that whatever comes here, 1, 2 or 3, it must be present inside these 6 cells, right? Because we know that 1, 2, 3 and 4 must be present in those 6 cells. So whatever is in this cell must be inside this cell. And now using the Knight's restriction, this cell, the value in this cell cannot be in these three cells, and using the Knight's move, it can be eliminated from these two cells also. So whatever is here, 1, 2 or 3 must be here as well, right? So which means you can eliminate the 4 from here. Now again, one more interesting deduction. If you look at this cell, this is also 1, 2 or 3. And regardless of whatever value goes into this cell, this also must be present in these 6 cells, because we just established it must contain 1, 2, 3 and 4. And now this cell cannot be in these 3 cells, and it also cannot be in these 2 cells, because it's at a Knight's move away. So whatever is here must be here. So what these 3 cells must be equal in value. Brilliant. Superb deduction, guys. This is a really superb deduction. Very tough to see. So all these 3 cells are equal in value. Now the next thing to see is, if you remember, the minimum sum from these 3 cells must be 4 and maximum from these 3 cells must be 6. So can you have a 3 here? If you have a 3 here, then you also have a 3 here, and then when you add that with maybe whatever value comes here, that gets you more than 6. So you can eliminate the 3 from here, right? So this is not a 3 and this is not a 3. And this also must not be a 3 now, because we know that all these values are equal. Okay, I'm seeing a contradiction here. So can you see, can you have all these values as 2? Let us see what happens if all these values are 2. So this is 2, so this will be 2 and this will be 2. Right? Now what happens is that we know that these 2 cells must sum to 7 and these 2 cells must sum to 7 to satisfy the 9 total, because you have already 2 here, and 7 needs to be achieved without the 2, right? There are 3 values, 3 sum possibilities by which you can take 7, 1 plus 6, 2 plus 5 and 3 plus 4. So if you don't have 2 in those possibilities, so this must be 1, 6, right? 1, 6, I'm sorry. So this must be 1616 or 3434, and similarly this must be 1616 and 3434, right? Now the remaining digits left in this box are all except 1346219, so 5, 7 and 8, but 8 is already outside, so this must be 5 or 7. Now look what happens along this arrow stem. We know that this sum up to 9, and if you have a 2 here, then these 2 cells must sum up to 7. You can't have a 7 here obviously, so this must be a 5. And now if you have a 5 here, then this also must be 2, right? Because 5 plus 2 plus 2 is 9, but you can't have a 2 here. Now we are getting a contradiction, right? So you cannot have 2 in all these 3 cells. Superb. I'm not sure if there is anything simpler, but there may be some other sharp deduction in the Sudoku, but this is the best I could see, right? So these cells cannot be 2, because we just saw what happened if it's a 2. So all these 3 cells must be a 1, right? And now this is not a 1, so this is 2, 3 or 4. And now using the same idea, these 2 cells must sum up to 8 to satisfy the 9, and similarly these 2 cells must sum up to 8 to satisfy the 9, and that 8 sum must be reached without the 1. So the only possibilities left are 2, 6 and 3, 5, right? 1, 7 is ruled out, so 2, 6 and 3, 5, 2, 6, 2, 6, 3, 5, 3, 5, 2, 6, 2, 6 and 3, 5, 3, 5. Now we have a quadruple 2, 3, 5, 6 here. So the remaining candidates are 4, 7 and 8 in box 1, because 1, 9, 2, 3, 5, 6 are ruled out. So this is 4 or 7, because 8 is already outside. This is 4, 7, 8, this is 4, 7 and 8. Wow, just to write some candidates inside box 1, I think we have taken close to 15 minutes maybe, but really worth it. So now if you look at this stem again, you cannot have 7 here, because if this is 7, this must be 1, but 1 is not possible. So this is a 4, which means this is a 4, and these 2 cells must be 7, 8, right? Okay, nice. So we have fit this biggest arrow now. It's really remarkable and amazing to see just how this single arrow is just, you know, driving the Sudoku, guys. There is no information in the Sudoku whatsoever except this thing to start the Sudoku. So let us come over to this arrow now. It seems natural, and we have 2 arrows coming out from this arrow sum. So what can be here? Cannot be 1, 2, 9 because 9 is here. Cannot be a 3 because 3 is 1 and 2 and 1 is already here. Cannot be a 4. So it can only be 5, 6, 7, or 8. Can you have a 5? 5 can be 1, 4, and 2, 3, but 1 is already ruled out and we need to have 2 sum possibilities. So 5 is also ruled out. And you also cannot have 6 because 6 is 1 plus 5 and 2 plus 4, but 1 is already ruled out. So 6 is also not possible. So it is going to only be 7 or 8. 7 can be 2 plus 5 and 3 plus 4, which is possible, and 8 can be 1 plus 7 is ruled out. So 2 plus 6 and 3 plus 5. So both are possible now. Okay, 9 is in column 1 and 9 cannot be in any of the arrow sums. So 9 must be in these cells. And we have a pair here, right? 7, 8 pair. So 7, 8 cannot be here. And 7 and 8 cannot be in any of these cells, right? Because if you have 7 here, then this becomes 8 and we need a 1 to satisfy the total. So 7 and 8 cannot be anywhere here. And they also cannot be here, right? Superb. So we get a 7, 8 pair now in box 4. Because if you have a 7 or 8 here, then you'll eliminate both of these possibilities. If you have a 7 here, you cannot have 7 due to the knight's restriction, and you also cannot have the 7. And similarly, if you have an 8 here, you cannot have the 8 and the 8 here due to the knight's restriction. So this also cannot be 7, 8. These 4 cells cannot be 7, 8. This cannot be 7, 8 because 7, 8 pair. So this must be a 7 or 8. And now we get only one cell for the 9 in that box. 9 has to go here, right? There is no other cell left for the 9. Okay, so the 4 is playing a part now. The 4 cannot go here, 4 cannot go here, 4 cannot go here. So only one cell left for the 4, so 4 has to be here. Oh, the power is gone, guys. I hope you don't mind. Okay, so you have a 4 here now, which means that the 8 cannot go inside the arrow sum, right? Because if it is an 8, then you must have 4 plus 4, which is not possible. So which means this is a 7 and this must be a 3. So this is an 8 because 7, 8 pair, and that gives a 7 here and an 8 here. And now remaining candidates left are 2, 5 and 6. So this must be 2 and 5, right? Oh, sorry. I'm unable to see even my keyboard. I hope the power comes soon. So this must be a 2, 5. So this must be a 6, right? So this is a 6. And this cannot be a 6 now. So which means that this cannot be a 2, right? Because these two add up to 8 to satisfy the 9 total. Okay, you can't have 3 in these two cells because 3 is here. So this is not a 3 and this is not a 3. So which implies that 3 must be in these two cells. And if you have a 3 here, so this must be 5. And if you have a 3 here, this must be 5. So in both cases, 5 must be in one of these two cells. So 5 can be eliminated from here and here. Nice. So how do we go about it now? Okay, so if you look at this circle now, the minimum sum is going to be 1 plus 2 plus 3, which is 6, right? So it can be anything more than 6 or equal to 6. So 6, 7, 8, 9 are the possibilities. But this sum is also equal to this cell because the arrow is pointing here. So this is also equal to 6, 7, 8 and 9. But you cannot have 7, 8, 9 in column 3. So this must be a 6 and this must be a 6. And now these three cells must be 1, 2 and 3, right? Because 6 when pointing to 3 cells must be 1, 2 and 3. The minimum total. So you can't have 1 here, so this is 2 and 3 and 1 must be in one of these two cells. And 6 is eliminated from here, so this cannot be a 6, which means this cannot be a 2. And you have a 5, 6 pair and a 2, 3 pair. Beautiful. So we are getting some good progress in the Sudoku. I really apologize, guys. The power, I hope the power comes soon, but I hope you guys don't mind really. So along column 3, 1, 6, 7, 8, 9 are placed already. Remaining are 2, 3, 4 and 5, right? So let us write the candidates 2, 3, 4 and 5. And now this cannot be 2 or 5, right? Because if you have a 2 or 5 here, then using the knight's move, both these possibilities will be eliminated. So this is not a 2 or a 5. Right, so this can only be 3 or 4. That's fine. Okay. So, can we eliminate any digit using the knight's restriction? I don't think so. Okay, 3 is jumping here. 3 is at a knight's move from this cell. So, this cannot be a 3. So, this is a 2, 4 or a 5. Alright, there doesn't seem to be much here. Let us maybe look at this arrow now, because it seems to be very restricted. 3 values are already knocked out. 3, 4, 8 are ruled out from here, and 1 and 2 are obviously ruled out. So remaining digits are 5, 6, 7 and 9 are the candidates. Can you have a 5 here? If you have a 5 here, then these two cells must be either 1, 4 or 2, 3. 1, 4 is ruled out, and even 2, 3 is ruled out, right? Because you have 2 in one of these cells. And 3 is at a knight's move from this cell. So even 2, 3 is ruled out. So this is not a 5. Can you have a 6 here? 6 is also not possible. If you have a 6 here, then you must either have 2 plus 4, not possible, or 1 plus 5. So this cell cannot be 1 or 5. So 1, 5 is also ruled out. So this cell can't be a 6. So it can only be 7 and 9. Okay, you have a 5 in one of these two cells, right? So we can make the 5 here, mark the 5 here. This is a 5, this is a 2, and this removes the 5 from this cell, right? So this cannot be a 5, so this is 2 or 4. And now we have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. So remaining candidates are 7, 8 and 9. Let us, so this cells must be 7, 8 and 9. Okay, so can you have a 7 in this cell? If you have a 7, then these two cells must be 1 plus 6, 2 plus 5 or 3 plus 4, right? 1 plus 6 is ruled out because it cannot go here. And 2 and 5 is also ruled out because 2 and 5 is here. And even 3, 4 is ruled out because 4 is here. Superb. So this must be a 9, right? And which implies that for the 9, it is either 1 plus 8. 1 plus 8 seems to be possible. 2 plus 7 also seems likely. Okay, 2, 7 is not possible, right? You have 2, 7 here, which means 2 plus 7 is not possible. 3 plus 6 is also ruled out because 6 cannot go here and 3 cannot go here. So 3 plus 6 is ruled out and 4 plus 5 is ruled out. So only possible candidate is 1 and 8, right? Okay, so 1 cannot go here, which means that this must be a 2 or a 3. So 1 has to go here. And now we can use the knight's move here. So because you have 2 in one of these 2 cells, you cannot have a 2 here, because if this cell is a 2, then you eliminate 2 from both of these cells, because 2 here eliminates the 2 from here, and using the knight's move also eliminates the 2 from here. So this is a 4, this is a 3, this is a 2, and this must be a 6 now, because these add up to 8, so that you get a total of 9. And this must be a 3 and a 5 now. Beautiful, beautiful guys. So this 3 gives us a 2 here and a 3 here. And remaining candidates here are 1, 2 and 5, right? 7, 8, 9, 3, 4, 6. So 1, 2 and 5 are the candidates. Right. So let us write the candidates now. So this must be 1, 2, 5. And you have 1 and 2 here. So this must be a 5. And which means that this must be 1 and 2. And this must be 1 and 2. Right. So you have a 7 here. So this cannot be a 7. And you have an 8 here, so this cannot be 8. Knight's move, fine. So if you look along column 4, we have marked 1, 4, 8, 3 and 6. So remaining digits are 2, 5, 7 and 9. So 9 cannot be here, and using the knight's move, 2 cannot be here. So this is going to be 5 or 7. And this cannot be a 5 or a 7. So this can only be 2 or a 9. Sorry, I'm unable to see my keyboard, guys. So this is 5 and this, okay, 2 and 9. And this cannot be 7 and 9, so this can only be a 2 or a 5. Okay, and this can only be 5, 7 or 9, right? So, yeah, this can only be 5, 7 or 9. Okay, you cannot have 6 in row 4 and 6 cannot be here using the knight's move. So, 6 must go here and 2 cannot be in column 5 now. So, 2 must go here. So, remaining candidates are 3, 5 and 7, right? 3, 5, 7, 3, 5, 7. Okay, you cannot have 5, 7 here. So, this must be a 3 and this must be a 5 and a 7. And this 2 is at a knight's move from this cell. So, 2 can be eliminated from here. So, this is a 9. So, this is not a 9. So, 5 and 7. And 5, 7 pair is there. So, this must be a 2. Fine. So, we have 6 candidates along row 6, which means these 3 cells must be 1, 4 and 9. Sorry, 1, 4 and... This must be 149. And now we have a powerful step. This cell cannot contain 14 or 9, right? Because if you have 1 here, it removes the 1 from here, and using the knight's restriction also removes the 1 from these two cells. So similarly for 4 and 9. So this cannot be 14 or 9. And it cannot be 1, 2, 3, 5, 6. So it can only be 7 or 8, right? 1, 2, 3, 5, 6, 4 and 9 are ruled out, so it can only be 7 or 8. So, which implies that 4 must be in one of these two cells, because 4 in row 8 has no other options left. And because of this, you can't have the 4 here, right? Because if this cell is a 4 now, then you remove both the possibilities of 4 using the knight step. So, this cannot be a 4. So, this is to be a 1 or a 9. And this 9 is at a knight's move from here, so which means this is a 1. This Sudoku is really tough, guys. It's not easy by any stretch of imagination. So these two cells must be 4-9 now. And I really apologize for the lack of power here. I expected it to be coming back soon, but it's not coming back. Okay, so along row 5, remaining candidates are 2, 5, 6 and 7. But if you look at this cell, it cannot be 2 and 6. So which means that this can only be 5 and 7. And now we have a 5-7 pair in row 5, so which means that these two cells must be 2-6, right? Only possible candidates left. So I'm just trying to really effectively see my deductions, because the power is off. Okay, you have a 9 in column 6 and 9 cannot be in these two cells now, so 9 has only one cell left, so this must be a 9 for box 8. Alright, so 4 cannot be here, so 4 has only one cell left, so this must be a 4, and remaining candidates are 5, 7 and 8, right? Fine. So 8 is at a knight's move from this cell, and 8 cannot be here, so 8 has to go here. This is a 8, so this must be 5, 7, right? Okay, we are having something going on with the 5, 7s here, not really sure what. So we have 1, 4, 9, 2 and 6, right? And remaining candidates are 3, 5, 7 and 8. So let me write them. So 3, 5, 7, 8, right? Yep. And now we have again a superb reduction. So because these 4 cells are 3, 5, 7, 8, this cell is able to see all of these cells, right? Let me highlight and show you the cells. This cell is able to see all of these cells because knight's move will remove these cells, and using classic rule you will also see these cells. So this cell cannot be 3, 5, 7, 8. It cannot be 1, 2, 3, 4. So this can only be 6 or a 9, right? Oh, let me remove the highlighting now. This can only be 6 or 9. Okay, fine. Can you have a 4 here? Yeah, 4 is possible. Okay, so if you look at column 8 now, 4 cannot be in these two cells, and 4 is already pencil marked here, so 4 cannot be in these two cells, so 4 must be in one of these two cells only. There is no other possibility for the 4. Can we remove the knight's move? No, not really. Okay, you have 2 in row 1, 2 in row 2, which means that 2 must be in one of these two cells. And along column 8 again, 2 cannot be in these three cells, and 2 cannot be in these three cells because we have a 2 pair here, 2-6 pair here. So which implies that 2 must go into one of these two cells. So again, nothing much. Tough one, guys, tough one. Wow, just wow. Look at this step, guys. So if you have a 5 here, let me highlight that. This must be a 7, right? So let me highlight it using a different color. So if you have a 5 here, so this must be a 7. And if you have a 7 here, this must be a 5. That is not relevant for now. So this cell must be yellow, because if this is something, this will be opposite of that. And this will be again opposite of this. So this will be the same as this. So this is again pink, going by the same logic. And because you have yellow here, so this must be a what is this? Purple, right? Purple. Now we have a terrific deduction, guys. According to me, this is the deduction of the Sudoku. Very tough to see, really. So can these cells, we know that are of the same color, and hence they must contain the same digit. So can they be 5? So what happens if both of these cells are 5? So if you have a 5 here and a 5 here, in box 9, where will you have the 5? 5 cannot be in row 9, 5 cannot be in row 8, and because 5 is here, and these two cells are at a night's move from this 5, these three cells will also be eliminated. So both of these cells cannot be a 5, right? They can only be a 7. Superb, superb deduction. So this must be a 7, this must be a 7, this must be a 5, this must be a 5, this must be a 7, right? And we can remove the 7 from these cells. So they must be 3, 5, 8. And this 7 gives us an 8 here. Removes the pencil mark. Wait. Are these the only possibilities here? Yeah. So this must be an 8. So this must be a 9. Because 8 is here, this gives a 9 here. A 7 here. And an 8 here. Superb. So these two cells must be 4, 7 now. To complete the row. Alright. So if this is a 4, you have 1 plus 3 here, right? 1 and 3 will go here because 1 is here. And if this is a 7, it cannot be 1 and 6, cannot be 3 and 4, so it must be a 2 and 5, right? Alright, so if it is a 4, then this is 1 and 2. 1 and 3, I'm sorry. If this is a 7, then it must be a 2 and 5. Awesome. So if you look at row 9 carefully, you cannot have the 5 here because it is at a night's move. So 5 must be in one of these two cells, which means that this cell cannot be a 4. So this must be a 7, and which means that this must be a 2-5 pair now for the sum to be satisfied. And this 2 gives us a 1 here, a 2 here. And 2, we already know that must be in one of these two cells. Now it cannot go here. So this must be a 2. So this must be a 5. And this must be a 3 to satisfy the row, so this must be a 4. And now these three cells must be 1, 6 and 9. So let me write the candidates. So you have a 1 here, so this cannot be a 1. And you have a 9 here, so this cannot be a 9 at a night's move away from this cell. And you have a 4 here, so which means you get a 9 here by classic part. So this is a 4. So 9 can be removed from this cell also, night's move. So this is not a 9, so this must be a 9, and 1, 6 must be in these two cells, right? And because 9 is here, so this cell must be a 6, and remaining candidates left along that row are 3, 4 and 5, right? So this is not an 8, this is a 3, 4, 5. Okay, we have a 5 here, so this is not a 5. You have a 3 here in column 7, so this is not a 3, so this is 5 and 8. Okay, this is not a 5, so this is a 3 or a 4. Sorry. This is a 3 and 4, right? Okay, let's look at column 6, 2, 6, 9, 1, 4, 5, so remaining are 3, 7 and 8. And remaining here are 1, 2, 9, 3, 7, 8, so 4, 5 and 6. But you have 4 and 6 here, so this must be a 5. And these two cells must be 4, 6 now. You have a 6 here, so this is a 4. This is a 6. You have a 7 here, so 7 cannot be here. Oh, I'm sorry. This is not a 7. It's really hard to find the digits, guys. I'm just, feeling the numbers. on the keyboard. So this cannot be 7, so this is 3-8, so this must be, this is also not a 7, so this is also 3-8, so this must be a 7. All right, so now remaining candidates along row 3 are 2-3-4, right? So this is 2-3-4 and this is 2-3-4. You have 4 in column 7 and 9, so this must be a 4. So these two cells must be 2 and 3. You have a 3 here, so this must be a 3. This must be a 2. This must be a 2. This must be a 6. This must be a 6. This must be a 1. Superb. So we are really close to completing the Sudoku. Now we have a 3 here, so which means this must be 8. This must be a 3. And remaining digits along row 9, row 2 are 7 and 9. Let me mark them. So 7 is here, so which means this is a 7. This is a 9. And these three cells must be 1, 5 and 8, right? 6, 7, 9, 2, 3, 4. So this is a 1 because 1 is here. This is an 8 and this is a 5, which gives a 3 here, an 8 here and a 5 here. And with that, we have completed this tremendous Sudoku. The start was really, really narrow. I think the Sudoku is pretty hard. I'm not sure about the difficulty level. I haven't yet checked, but this is really stunning construction, guys. Just this arrow was driving the entire Sudoku, and we progressed towards this arrow, and then slowly we started getting the numbers. I hope you guys enjoyed watching me solve this Sudoku by Tenali Raman. Please let us know your thoughts in comments if you found any step better than us. We'll be happy to know that. We hope to see you all soon with a video. Take care. Bye-bye.